Meet Peter Somogyi. He was born in 1933 to a Jewish family in Hungary. They had a happy life. But when the Nazis invaded in 1944, their lives were changed forever.
It changed totally. First of all, immediately my father was taken away. Within a month, we had to go into a ghetto. And within 2-3 months, we were put into ghetto cars and sent to Auschwitz. We were thrown out of the ghetto car. I saw a lot of German soldiers with guns drawn, and I saw the prisoners in prisoner guards already. And that's it, we lined up. Along came Mengele asking for twins.
Josef Mengele, a notorious Nazi doctor known as the Angel of Death, wanted twins for his medical experiments. He often decided who would live and who would die among those newly arriving at Auschwitz. Peter and his brother Thomas were twins. Their mother, unsure if volunteering her sons would save their lives or doom them, had an impossible decision to make.
3 times Mengele came around, 3 times. First time she didn't say anything, second time she didn't say anything. When my mother, for the third time, said she had twins, they grabbed us, there's 2 soldiers behind them, grabbed us, put it into an ambulance and drove into us an F-lager in Birkenau. The man who was in charge of, at that time, Mengele put one of the older twins in charge of the twins. And the first thing I asked him, where did I see my mother? And he said, look outside over there, the chimneys, and he said, that's where your mother is. So finally, immediately I knew, I'll never see her again. Every night I went hungry. Just enough to keep us. We're not starving, but I was constantly hungry. Well, I was a very lucky one. We didn't have the bad experiments that Mengele did at the beginning. But measuring the face, measuring the size, blood taking, and mostly measuring every part of the body. It didn't save me life. It has kept me alive for its own purpose. Extremely polite. But you know, behind this politeness was the murderers. One day, I think it was October something, mid-October, another Nazi officer came around and they did a selection and selected us. And we were locked into another room and waited for the truck to take us to the gas chamber. Except Mengele got wind of it. He says, no, I will decide when these people will die. So he sent this other officer to the Russian front as a punishment.
Peter and his brother survived several months in Auschwitz. There's no doubt in Peter's mind that if he wasn't a twin, he wouldn't be here today.
No, definitely not. I would have been with my mother and my sister together. We have been in the gas chamber within 5 minutes after arrival. Because they were, my mother, my sister, my grandmother, all the cousins, they were in the same cattle car. They all perished within an hour. After liberation, we started walking. From my hometown to Auschwitz took us 3.5 days. From Auschwitz to hometown was 2.5 months. Then sometimes we got trucks, sometimes we got railroad cars, but going towards east. But it was a month and a half or 2 months until we got somewhere, until we arrived at Hungary. My father survived Dachau. First, he didn't want to come back because he saw that everybody was dead. Somehow, he found out that his twin boys survived. That's why he came back. Otherwise, he wouldn't even come back to Hungary. Yeah. Hometown where I lived had 4,000 Jews. Out of 4,000, at least 1,000 plus were children. I think 2 came back and 1 girl.
If living well is the best revenge, then the twins have won in the end. Today, each brother has built a family of his own.
First of all, anti-Semitism never stopped, even after the war. And that I got involved in the Zionist movement. And age 16, we escaped Hungary from Slovakia, Czechoslovakia to Vienna, down to Salzburg, Italy, and that way, and went into Israel. I was 7 years in Israel, 2 years in the kibbutz, nearly 3 years in the army, additional 2 years in the workforce. And then we went to England. I stayed in England 2 years, went to Canada, 1970 moved on here. I hope it never happens again. That's all what I can say. It should never happen again.